Welcome student, today our Kriyashari lecture topic is Introduction to Tridosha Concept. As you all you know about that Ayurveda science is based on different fundamental concept. Among them, Tridosha concept is considered as one of the important concept of the Ayurveda. So let we discuss about the Tridosha concept. So Shushru said that Dosh Dhatu Malumulami Sharira. It means that as per the Ayurveda physiology concern, our body is nothing but it is the functional conglomeration of the Dosh Dhatu and Mal. So these are the three main bio energies of our body, or bio constructive forces of our body, which regulate, coordinate the all the bodily function within the normal physiological point of way. Among them, dosh is considered as a karyakari dravya of the body. It means which is a functional biological entity. Dhatu, which is considered as upadan dravya of the deha, which bear, support and nourish the body. It means it is one of the constructive unit of the our body. Mala, which is considered as a kita dravya, ahara mala, or which is produced in our body as a unwanted and waste product. So here we are seen that we have seen that our body is the basically composed by the three main entities, dosh, dhatu and mal. It means that these are the three main pillars of the our body. So here we are focusing on the dosh. So in Yajurveda there is one stanza is there, it indicating that yatha pinde tatha brahmande. It means the whatever the entities that we are seen in the universe, the same entities may be seen in our human body, or whatever the entity which are observed in the human body, the same entities may be seen in the external world. It means that as is the human body, so is the cosmic body, and as is the cosmic body, so is the human body. So why I am discussing about this? So before going to the fundamental definition of the dosha, I will correlate the dosha with the cosmic body, so it may give you some idea about the what about the dosha. So here we are going to understand the dosha concept by comparing the Tridosha with the cosmic body. Shushrut said that Swissargadan Vikshepo Soma Surya Anil Yata Daryanti Jagat Deham Kaf Pit Anil Stata. In the cosmic environment, three main forces can be recognized as a Soma or moon, Surya or sun, and Anil as a air, with their action, Visarga, Adhan and Vikshep. In the same way, the body is maintained by three biological building block energies, namely Kapha, Pitta and Vata, having the same qualities and action respectively. It means that the sun is resembled as a Pitta in our body, and the moon, which is correlated or resemble as a Kapha in our body, and the anil or wind or air, external air, which is correlated or which is resemble as a human body's vayu dosha, and the visarga, adhan and viksha. These are the three main fundamental function mediated by the Soma, Surya, Anil in the external world, and cough pitta vayu in the internal one. Visarg, which is the function of the cough. Visarg means that vruddhi or upche, which is responsible for the growth development of the body and which is provide the stability in our body. So cough main function is the growth development and stability, providing the stability. Adhan means that parinaman and satmikaran. So this is the function of the pitta dosh in our body. And sun of the external world. So it is responsible for the biological transformation and assimilation. And vikshep means the movement or to move one entity from one place to other place or movability. So it is the function of the vata dosh. So though kapha pitta have their own function, but to do so they need some stimulation. So that is done by the vata dosha. So it may be more properly understood by following stanzas. That is pittam pangu kapham pangu pangamallatava vayuna yatra niyante gacchanti megavat. Pit and kaf are the lung, or they are dormant, and mal and dhatu are lame as well as they are driven by the vata, as the clouds are driven by the wind from place to place, one place to other place. Second, sitansu kledati urvi vivasvan sosyatipi taubapi sansrita vayu palayati praja. Moon moisture the earth and sun desiccate the earth. Vayu, by coordinating each other, protect the human body. It means that vayu is the stimulator and activator for the remaining dosha, dhatu and malu. So without vayu stimulation, they can't do their function properly. It means that to do their function, they need some activation or stimulation. So that activation stimulation is provided by the vayu dosha. So that is why it is called as the main activator of the our body. Now move on to the second concept, other concept, that is sarvadravyam panchabhautikam asminarthe. So Sarek says that entire world and everything in it is made up by the five main elements. So that five main elements are Prithvi, Jal, Tej, Vayu and Akash. It means that whatever the entity which are present in outside and whatever the entity which are present in inside, and what either it is living or non-living, whatever the entities are there, they basically composed by the five Mahabhuta. So it means that those are also composed by the five main Mahabhutas. So Vayu is basically constituted by the Pancha Mahabhuta, but with the dominancy of the Vayu and Akash. And Pitta Dosha, which is derived from the with the dominancy of the Agni Mahabhuta. And Shleshma Maha, Shleshma Dosha or Kapha Dosha, which is developed by the with the dominancy of the Prithvi and Jal Mahabhuta. So according to Mahabhuta dominance, this Vata Pitta Kapha Dosha possesses some specific characteristic feature. For example, Vayu Ruksha Lagu Sita Kara Sushma Chala Guna, and Pitta Ushna Tishna Drava Amla Sar Katu Guna, and Kapha Guru Snigna Mand Asna Guru Sita Mand Snigna Chal Asnigda Pichil. So these are the characteristic features that Kapha is having. So it means that on the basis of the dominancy of the Pancha Mahabhuta, this specific dosha possesses this specific characteristic feature. On the basis of that, they exhibit this specific function and coordinate, regulate the all your body function within the normal way. So in this way, the three biological entities or control the all the bodily activities from the birth to till death. पंचभूतात्मक देह आहार पंचभौतिकम विपक्व पंचदा सम्यक स्वान गुणाना भी वर्धयेत। एज द बॉडी इज कंस्टिट्यूटेड बाय द फाइव मेन एलिमेंट्स द डायटिक फैक्टर आर आल्सो सो दे नरिशेड द एलिमेंट इन द बॉडी एज द सर्वदा सर्वभावान सामान्य वृद्धिकरण मास हेतु विशेष प्रवृत्ति रूपेस्य तु प्रिंसिपल। इट मीन्स द वन विच कॉज increase in the substance having the similar group of a particular group, so they are the samanya, and in contrary vishesh one which cause the decrease in substance. It means that whenever you take the same guna dravya, so same guna dosha will be increase in our body. So whenever you reduce the the same guna dravyas in our body, the same guna dosha will be reduced, and whenever intake the opposite characteristic food substance in our body, so the particular dosha may be reduced in our body. For example, dravya which one reach in akash and vayu mahabhuta, so that dravya will be aggravate or will be maintain the vata dosha in our bodies, and the dravya or substance that we are consuming, so they are the prithvi and jala mahabhuta characteristic constitution, so they may increase or maintain the kapha dosha in our body, and the substance which is having agni dominancy, it may aggravate or it may develop the pitta dosha in our body. For example, if you consume the soot which is having ushna guna, it means that it having a dominance of agni mahabhuta. Whenever you consume the agni mahabhuta or soot which have a agni mahabhuta characteristic feature, it develop the or which stimulate the pitta dosha in our body. So why I am discussing about this? Because in our body, due to the continuous paka kriya, so the dosha degeneration is take place constantly. So to maintain the homeostasis in our body, their replacement should be done, and that replacement is done by the type of the food that we are consuming. So if we consume the same characteristic futuric dietics, so the same characteristic future dosha may be developed in our body, and it may replace the reduction of the dosha dosha concentration in our body. So whenever you and further whenever we intake the food which are prithvi agni jala mahabhuta dominancy, they may reduce the vata dosha, and if we consume the substance which having the prithvi jala vayu dominancy, they reduce the pitta dosha. And the food or substance which is having the akash agni vayu dominancy, they reduce the kapha dosha. So if you have a proper knowledge about it, you can maintain the dosha status normal by following the proper diet regimen according to pancha mahabhuta attribute related diet regimen which are concerned with the dosha characteristic feature. So up to till we just discuss general about the dosha, we have not discussed about the definition of the dosha. So let we start the or focus on the what is the classical definition of the. So whenever we say dosha, so in Sanskrit dosha means the vitiation or distorted or impaired, but as per the Ayurveda perspective, Dallan said that dosha is nothing but which is concerned with the vata, pitta and kapha. So as per the Siddhanta Nidan, so what is the definition of the dosha? Dushyanti mana shariram cheti dosha. So the entity which is having a tendency or capacity to vitiate the mind and body, so that entity may be termed as a dosha. So as per the Madhukosh Vakya, prakruti arambhakatve sati svatantyen drishti karanam doshatvam. So it means that the entity which is though responsible for the development of the individual constitution, it may produce the vitiation of pathology in our body. So that is considered as a. So in Yajurveda there is even stanza is there, it indicating that yatha pinde tatha brahmand. It means the whatever the entities that we are seen in the universe, the same entities may be seen in our human body, or whatever entity which are observed in the human body, the same entities may be seen in the external world. It means that as is the human body, so is the cosmic body, and as is the cosmic body, so is the human body. So why I am discussing about this? So before going to the fundamental definition of the dosha, I will correlate the dosha with the cosmic body. So it may give us some idea about the what about the dosha. So we are going to understand the dosha concept by comparing the tridosha with the cosmic body. Sushrut said that Swissargadan Vikshepo Soma Surya Anil Yata Daryanti Jagat Deham Kaf Pit Anil Stata. In the cosmic environment, three main forces can be recognized as a Soma or Moon, Surya or Sun, and Anil as a air with their action, Visargadan and Vikshep. In the same way, the body is maintained by three biological building block energies, namely kapha, pitta and vata, having the same qualities and action respectively. It means that the sun is resemble as no, as per the Ashtangodaya Sutra Sthan 1, vata pitta kapha kshati trayodosh samasa vikrita vikrita deham dhyanti te vartyanti. Vata, pitta, kapha, these are the three dosha. If they are normal in status, so they are responsible for regulate the homeostasis or maintain the homeostasis. If it is vitiated, or which is abnormal, so which create the different pathology in our body. So and as per the Tridosh Charcha Parishad or as per the Tridosh Vignan, so what is the definition of the dosha? Sharira jayamananam kriyadinam pravartak prakruti janiyet vishma roga karak sama sanjaniyet swastham sa tridosha parikhet. So this is the definition from the Tridosh Vignan, not the Tridosh Charcha Parishad. It is mistakenly written. So this definition is taken from the Tridosh Vignan. So what is the meaning of this stanza? Sharira jayamananam kriyadinam pravartak. So it is activator or stimulator, coordinator of the all bodily function. Prakruti janiyat, which is responsible for the development of the individual constitution. Visamo rogakara, if it is in visam form, it is in abnormal form, is responsible for the create the different disease in our body. Sama sanjanet swastham, so if it is in normal form or normal status, which is represent the health of the our body. So whatever the substance which possess the this type of the characteristic feature, so that substance may be termed as a dosha. So dosha, so we are observed the so many definition by the so many physician. But in this light of the current scientific era, so by briefing the, by concising the all this definition, by so we can conclude the this dosha definition in the scientific form by this way. Dosha is considered as a bioenergy which is coordinate the all the bodily function, which is one of the major influencing factor for the formation of the individual constitution, which is basically constituted by the panchamahabhutas. On the basis of the dominant panchamahabhuta, it possesses the specific attributes and execute the specific function accordingly. So in its normal status, responsible for the maintenance of the body, so homeostasis, and while in its abnormal status is responsible for the creating the pathology. So this is the basic definition of the dosha. So what are the substance which is possess the this type of the characteristic feature, and mainly so the property of the dosha is the having a tendency to vitiate itself and vitiate body and mind in its abnormal status. It means that the dosha has a capacity to vitiate the other entities, but if it is in normal in status, it is responsible for the maintaining the homeostasis. But it is in abnormal status, is responsible for the creating the pathology by disturbing the homeostasis in our body. And dosha basically derived from the panchamahabhuta. But on the basis of the dominancy of a particular panchamahabhuta, it possesses the specific characteristic feature or attributes. So on the basis of that attribute, it executes the specific function. So it is about the general introduction of the tridosha. In next coming lecture, we will discuss one by one deeply. So it is about today's lecture. I hope you may get the any understanding about the dosha.